Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Ruchika Divedi, and my presentation is on topic Crime Scene of John Bennett Ramsey. John Bennett Ramsey was a child beauty pageant participant who have won many titles, including America's Royal Miss and Little Miss Colorado, living with her mother, father, and brother. The case actually started just after 5 a.m. on December 26, 1996, when Patsy Ramsey, her mother, awoke and walked downstairs her kitchen, and downstairs she found a 2.5 long page letter mentioning that the John Bennett has been kidnapped. The note contained the ransom demand of $118,000. When police arrived to investigate, it was quite apparent that John Bennett was missing. In retrospect, there have been some serious mistakes on securing the crime scene. The police conducted a cursory search of the house but failed to find John Bennett. The house was not sealed off. In fact, four friends along with John Ramsey was allowed to come in and out of the home. John was also permitted to leave the premise unattended for almost about 1 hour. And after his return, John and his friend again allowed to search the house to find any clues for her daughter. And this time John went down to the basement where he discovered her daughter's body. And then he removed the blanket, which was on the John Bennett body. And he put her and came out in the living room. The murder, during the autopsy, it was discovered that John Bennett's had died from the asphyxiations due to strangulation. In addition to a skull fracture, her mouth has been covered with a duct tape and her wrist and neck was wrapped with a white cord. Her torso has been covered with white blanket. And there was no conclusive evidence for the rape as no semen was found on her body. And a vagina appeared to have been wiped clean. Although the sexual assault has occurred and the makeshift garret was made using the length of cord and a part of paintbrush. The coroner also reported the pineapple in John Bennett's stomach before she dies, but her parent didn't remember their giving her any pineapple meal before the night before when she died. And in this case, there are always the two theories of family and a intruder theory. It is primarily initial investigation, mainly focused on the Ramsey family for many reasons. The police felt that ransom note was staged as it was unusually long and written using a pen and a notepad from the Ramsey house and demanded almost exact amount of money that John has received at the bonus earlier that year. Additionally, the Ramseys were reluctant to cooperate with police. However, both three family members have been collected for the handwriting sample and that was compared. And her father, John, and her brother, Brooke, was cleared out of any suspicion of writing the note. Although her mother could not conclusively clear out of the suspicion in her handwriting. And the analysis was not further supported by any other evidence. Alternatively, there was another theory of intruder, which has been supported by many physical evidence that there was a boot print found next to the John Bennett body, which was not belong to anyone in the family. Second, there was a broken window in the basement, which was believed to be the most likely point of entry of an intruder. Additionally, there was a DNA from the blood drop of unknown male found from the underwear of the John Bennett. And then most interestingly came the another story of John Carr, who falsely confessed to killing John Bennett by accident. According to him, he had kidnapped her from school, but that day was holiday of Christmas Eve. He also confessed that he had drugged and sexually assaulted her, and during which the girl died. But but during the investigation it was revealed that in toxicology report that there was no drug found in the John Bennett's body, and also the DNA profile did not match with the John Kerr, so he was eventually dismissed as a suspect after it. And then in much recent investigation, the case revolves around DNA profile developed from the sample found in the underwear and the touch DNA letter developed from Long John's. The profile from her underwear was entered in the CODIS in 2003, but no match had been found. In 2006, in Boulder District Attorney, Mary Lacey took over the case, and she agreed with the federal prosecutors that intruder theory was more plausible then the Ramses killing their daughter. So with this, Lacey released a statement letter in 2008 detailing that the DNA evidence and fully exonerating the Ramses family. In 2010, there was officially reopened the case, and it was renewed focus on DNA sample. Further, the testing has been conducted on the sample, and experts now believe that the sample is actually from two individuals rather than one. In 2016, it was announced that the DNA would be sent to the Colorado Bureau of Investigation to be tested using for more modern methods and authorities to hope for develop an more stronger DNA profile of the killer. In 2016, there was also a rumor from CBS aired in this case that the John Bennett Ramsey's brother was the killer, but it was clear that from the DNA profile that he was not. So the Brooke also have filed $750 million of lawsuit against CBS for defamation, and the case was settled in 2019. And while the term of settlement was not disclosed, his lawyer stated that the case was amicably resolved to the satisfaction of all the parties. The John Bennett case is still open and remain unresolved. There are many unanswered questions, like whose DNA it was, why the exact amount of John Ramsey's bonus was mentioned in the ransom note, who wrote the ransom note, and most importantly, who had done it. The major point of concern is in this case is the lack of proper crime scene investigation. All the basic procedures were not properly followed in this case, which was the most major cause there, which makes this case more and more complex to resolve. The family was allowed to go in and out again and again. The friends and family allowed to search the scene without any investigating officer. The body, which was the main evidence in this case, was moved several times position to position, which must also have cross-contaminated or wiped off some valuable evidence. The prime suspect, which was at that time of the family, was not properly interrogated. And no one had worried about the ransom call, which was clearly mentioned in the ransom note that it would be on between 9 to 10 a.m., but that was never came along. And also there was a lot of influence of media and society in this case, which also affect the proper handling of the scene and physical evidence and opinions of witness. So the murder of John Bennett Ramsey remains as baffling a mystery today as it was on the first day. And perhaps the better care at securing and processing the crime scene could have been resolved some of the questions of this case to some extent. With this, I would like to thank all the jury members and everyone to patiently listening my presentations. Thank you, sir.